The blue-roofed guest house overlooks the ranch. Every night, I would stand near the fence to watch as the moon rose and the sun made its descent, creating a line of light and dark across the valley. The striking blue of the mountains and ponds contrasted against the dull yellow of the landscape. One day, I went on a hike up the mountain with one of the ranch managers, Jen. We drove as far up as we could in her old blue truck, then hiked up the mountainside, where the last accumulation of snow remained. On the way back down, I even got to meet her old horse, Blue. Out of all the animals I saw, I may have been most excited to see the pronghorn. One morning, I happened to glance out the window, only to do a double take. Right near the end of the driveway, a harem of pronghorn were running around. Despite wearing only shorts and a t-shirt, I ran straight to my car, grabbing my camera too, of course, jumped in, and drove as close to them as I could. Standing outside my car, wearing next to nothing to shield myself against the 30-degree weather, I'm sure I looked absolutely insane to the bearded local who drove by. He surely sees them all the time and thinks nothing of them. I, however, was overjoyed to finally get close enough to the animals for usable footage. Directly outside the guest house was an old farm structure frequented by a pair of red-tailed hawks. I would often glance out the living room window to see them back yet again. Every now and then, they'd bring a ground squirrel, seemingly their favorite prey, back for a meal. According to one of the ranch's managers, there is never a shortage of ground squirrels around the ranch. They cause more damage to the fields than just about anything else, so he was glad that the hawks liked them so much. While on a day trip exploration to Ennis, the largest town nearby, I came across a herd of mule deer on a back road. I remember cracking up while on the phone with my mom videoing this little doe. These deer were largely unbothered by me, taking their time before deciding to jog off into someone's yard, hopping the fence along the way. The white-tailed deer I came across on the ranch, however, spooked while I was still a good distance away. Even so, they were fun to watch next to the pond most nights. Different from most ranches, this particular one is mostly meant as a getaway for fishermen. They use the network of ponds and canals to fish. Sheridan receives only about 11 inches of rain per year, meaning that all sorts of wildlife are attracted to the water on the ranch. One such visitor was a moose. We had a bit of a stare down from across the house pond before she ran off, chasing away three deer in the process. Out of all the birds on the ranch, the sandhill cranes were the loudest and easiest to approach. They seemed to care little about my presence, instead focusing on their ritual mating dances and noisy calls. I would wake up most mornings, bright and early, to their raucous song. As a late winter storm rolled in, animals all across the valley arose a cacophony of alarm calls. The snow, though beautiful, did not last long. One of my favorite furry friends had to be this little muskrat who appeared at the aptly named Duck Pond every time I scared all the waterfowl off from it. Mostly unbothered by me, he'd emerge from the water to sit on the ice before diving down once again and disappearing for the night. On my final night, I once again stood by the fence, watching as the geese migrated, some seen here beneath the rising moon.